Dear people of God, in this season of Advent, it is our responsibility and joy to prepare ourselves to hear once more the message of the angels, to go to Bethlehem and see the Son of God lying in a manger. Let us hear and heed in Holy Scripture the story of God's loving purpose from the time of our rebellion until the glorious redemption brought to us by the Holy Child, Jesus. And let us look forward to the yearly remembrance of Jesus' birth with hymns and songs of praise. But first, let us pray for the needs of the whole world, for peace and justice on earth, for the good purposes of this university and all places of learning, and especially for this country and for our city of New York. And because Jesus particularly loves them, let us remember in Jesus' name the poor and helpless, the cold, the hungry, and the oppressed, the sick and those who mourn, and especially all who are afflicted with COVID and all who care for the sick, the lonely and unloved, the aged and little children, as well as all those who are searching for God, for love, and for peace. Finally, let us remember Jesus' bold and humble mother and that whole multitude which no one can number, whose hope was in the Word made flesh, and with whom, in Jesus, we are one forevermore. And now, to gather all these petitions, let us pray in the words which Christ himself has taught us, saying, Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. The Almighty God bless us with grace. Christ give us the joys of everlasting life. And to the fellowship of the citizens above, may the King of angels bring us all. Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. The man and his wife heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden at the time of the evening breeze, and they hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God among the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called to the man and said to him, Where are you? And he said, I heard the sound of you in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, and I hid myself. He said, Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree of which I commanded you not to eat? The man said, The woman whom you gave to be with me. She gave me fruit from the tree, and I ate. Then the Lord God said to the woman, What is this that you have done? And the woman said, The serpent tricked me, and I ate. The Lord God said to the serpent, Because you have done this, cursed are you among all animals and among all wild creatures. Upon your belly you shall go. And dust you shall eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, between your offspring and hers. He will strike your head, and you will strike his heel. And to the man he said, Because you have listened to the voice of your wife, and have eaten of the tree about which I commanded you, you shall not eat of it. Cursed is the ground because of you. In toil you shall eat of it all the days of your life. Thorn and thistles it shall bring forth for you. And you shall eat the plants of the field. By the sweat of your face you shall eat bread until you return to the ground, for out of it you were taken, you are dust, and to dust you shall return.
From the book of Genesis. The angel of the Lord called to Abraham a second time from heaven and said, "By myself I have sworn, says the Lord, because you have done this and have not withheld your son, your only son, I will indeed bless you. And I will make your offspring as numerous as the stars of heaven and as the sand that is on the seashore. And your offspring shall possess the gate of their enemies. And by your offspring shall all the nations of the earth gain blessing for themselves, because you have obeyed my voice."
Thank you. reading from the prophet Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this.
A shoot shall come out from the stump of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. His delight shall be in the fear of the Lord. With righteousness he shall judge the poor and decide with equity for the meek of the earth. The wolf shall live with the lamb. The leopard shall lie down with the kid. The calf and the lion and the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them. The cow and the bear shall graze. Their young shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox. The nursing child shall play over the hole of the asp, and the weaned child shall put its hand on the adder's den. They will not hurt or destroy on all my holy mountain, for the earth will be full of the knowledge of the Lord, as the waters cover the sea.
Rising up. A reading from the Gospel of Luke. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God." Then Mary said, "Here I am, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her.
Reading from the book of Luke. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn.
Thank you.
Gospel of Luke. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. See, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heavens, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angel had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, "Let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in a manger.
After Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet. And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel." Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact timing when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word so that I may also go and pay him homage." When they had heard the king, they set out. And there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road.
A reading from the Gospel of John. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life. And the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name. He gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood or of the will of the flesh or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth.
Let us pray. Purify our conscience, Almighty God, by your daily visitation, that your Son, Jesus Christ, at his coming, may find in us a mansion prepared for himself, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. I'm Mary Glasspool, Bishop Assistant in the Episcopal Diocese of New York, whose offices are adjacent to Columbia University. And I have the honor and privilege of working with the Reverend Ryan Kuratko, who is the Episcopal Chaplain to Columbia University. Ryan was on his way here and got caught up in traffic for an unfortunate accident on the Sawmill River Parkway. So I am welcoming you as a guest here at St. Paul's Chapel. And I'm glad you were able to join us, either via live stream or perhaps you're listening to this after the fact. My heart is just full of appreciation for Maria and Sebastian and James, our musicians, and to Maestro Julian. And here is Ryan. We can have the welcome then at the end. And then I'll give a final blessing.
Good evening. I simply want to say welcome. I'm Ryan Kuratko, the Episcopal Religious Life Advisor here at Columbia. And normally it would be my role to welcome hundreds of us gathered here this evening. I am deeply grateful for those of you who have come and worked with us this year in this very strange year. I'm deeply grateful to Bishop Mary for being here, to our bold musicians for being here, I deeply appreciate it, to Julian for all of your wonderful work, and to all of our readers and all who have contributed. I just simply want to say thank you. I also think we should probably just acknowledge what a strange year it is. Normally this is such a public time, such a public gathering, and of course we're in the year when we cannot do that. And we're hoping instead that we're gathering this evening online to have a little bit of space, a little bit of beauty in this time of the year. As we gather for this little bit of space, this little bit of beauty, I am just simply mindful of the stories that we have heard this evening and of the beauty that we have experienced. I am grateful for it, and I hope that wherever you have found yourself in this lonely and strange time, I hope that, like Mary, all of us can say yes to the strange, to the wonderful, and to God when God shows up. So, welcome all of you belatedly. I'm afraid I was literally stuck in traffic for most of the service, but I am grateful to have watched it online with all of you, and I am grateful for all of you. I'll defer to your blessing.
And I am grateful to see Ryan safe and sound. May God grant you the grace never to sell yourself short. Grace to risk something big for something good. Grace to remember that the world is now too dangerous for anything but truth, and too small for anything but love. And the blessing of the God who creates us, redeems us, and sustains us be upon us this night and forevermore. Amen.